Welcome to this video, part of our chemistry playlist on mole conversions. In this lesson, we're going to tackle one of the most common types of questions in chemistry. How do you convert moles into grams? We'll go through four examples together. Each one follows the same simple method, using the molar mass as a conversion factor. Let's begin with a key idea. In chemistry, the molar mass tells us how many grams are in one mole of a substance. So here's the basic relationship we'll use. One mole equals the molar mass in grams. That's our conversion factor, and it's all we need to solve these problems. Let's start with part A. We're given 0.15 moles of sodium, and we're asked to find the mass in grams. Step 1. Find the molar mass of sodium. From the periodic table, sodium has a molar mass of 22.99 grams per mole. This gives us our conversion factor. 1 mole Na equals 22.99 grams. Step 2. Write down what we're given. 0.15 moles of sodium. Now let's set up the conversion so that moles cancel out and we're left with grams. To do that, we multiply by a fraction. 1 mole goes on the bottom. 22.99 grams goes on the top. Here's how it looks. The unit mol cancels, and we're left with grams, just like we want. Now multiply. 0.15 times 22.99 equals 3.45 grams. So 0.15 moles of sodium equals 3.45 grams. Before we move on, here's a quick tip to help you set up these conversions with confidence every single time. When you're using a conversion factor, let the units be your guide. Place the unit you want to cancel on the bottom and the unit you want to end up with on the top. In our example, we wanted to cancel out moles and convert to grams, so we put moles on the bottom and grams on the top. Once your units are in the right place, the math becomes simple. Now, let's move on to part B. The question says, calculate the mass in grams of 0.594 moles of sulfur. So, we're given 0.594 moles of sulfur, and we need to convert this into grams. First, let's find the molar mass of sulfur. From the periodic table, the molar mass of sulfur equals 32.07 grams per mole. This gives us the conversion factor we'll use. 1 mole of sulfur equals 32.07 grams. Now, let's set up our conversion. We start with the number we're given, 0.594 mole. Then, we multiply by the conversion factor, placing moles on the bottom and grams on the top, so the unit mole cancels out. Here's what it looks like. Now, let's multiply. 0.594 times 32.07 equals 19.05 grams. So, the final answer is 0.594 moles of sulfur equals 19.05 grams. Now, let's move on to part C, where the question is, what is the mass in grams of 2.78 moles of CH2Cl2? But before we begin, let's take a moment to notice something important. In parts A and B, we worked with individual elements, sodium and sulfur, and simply looked up their molar masses. But in this example, we're dealing with a compound, CH2Cl2, also known as dichloromethane. That means we need to calculate its molar mass by adding together the masses of all the atoms in its formula. Once we do that, we'll use the same method as before. Multiply by the molar mass to find the mass in grams. CH2Cl2 contains one carbon atom with a molar mass of 12 grams per mole, 2 hydrogen atoms, each at 1 gram per mole, 2 chlorine atoms, each at 35.45 grams per mole. So, we calculate molar mass of CH2Cl2 equals 12 plus 2 times 1 plus 2 times 35.45, which gives 84.90 grams per mole. So now we know 1 mole of CH2Cl2 equals 84.90 grams.
Step 2. Write what we're given.
We're given 2.78 moles of CH2Cl. We want to convert moles into grams. Now we use the molar mass as a conversion factor. Remember this tip. Always place the unit you want to cancel on the bottom, and place the unit you want to end up with on the top. In this case, we want to cancel out moles and convert to grams, so we set it up like this. Notice how the unit mol appears once in the numerator and once in the denominator, so it cancels out. That leaves us with grams, which is exactly what we want. Now we multiply the numbers. And we arrive at our answer. 2.78 moles of CH2Cl2 is equal to 236.0 grams. Now, let's move on to part D. We're asked to calculate the mass of 38.00 moles of NH4 2S. Just like before, we'll follow the same steps. Beginning with the molar mass, which we'll use as our conversion factor. To calculate it, we need to look at the elements in the formula: molar mass of nitrogen, molar mass of hydrogen, and molar mass of sulfur. Now, let's break down the compound. The formula NH4 2S contains 2 nitrogen atoms, 8 hydrogen atoms, since each ammonium ion has 4 hydrogens, and there are 2 of them, and 1 sulfur atom. Now, let's calculate the total molar mass. After combining the contributions of each atom, we find the molar mass of NH4 2S is 68.09 grams per mole. Next, we'll use this as our conversion factor. So, we set up our conversion so that moles cancel out and grams remain, just like we've done before. Here's the result. 38 moles of NH4 2S equals 2,588 grams. And that brings us to the end of this video. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to ask in the comments. I'll be happy to help. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one.